Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. This is best UFC prospect you need to watch in 2024. Now, my first one is Carlos Prates. We seen him last night fight the Leech, Li Jialang. 18 finishes by Prates. Now, he's not perfect. He has lost six times. He's been finished five of those six times, but he's won 10 fights in a row where he's looked almost untouchable. The Leech, we all can say, he's older, he's not as durable as he used to be. First time he's ever been finished. First time the Leech has ever been finished. And it was not a competitive second in that matchup last night. It's a very, very interesting prospect. I like Carlos Prates, only 31 years old. Carlos Prates is an absolute monster. He's a freak, you know. Seven first round finishes. This is a guy who has seven in the second and one in the third. 75% of his wins are by finish, by TKO or KO. Does have three submission wins, has been submitted three times, has been finished two times on the feet. Again, the last time he was finished on the feet was against Mikhail Romachuk back in 2017. So again, okay, whatever. Whatever. This guy is unbelievable. He's so fun. He's charismatic as hell. This is a guy absolutely to look out for. Now, number four is Peyton Talbot. 9-0, hasn't fought the best competition right now, so we don't know 100%. That's why he's not at higher than this. Reason why Prates is as low as he is, because he's literally three fights in. Yes, he beat the Leech, who has never been finished before, but Peyton Talbot is above him in that aspect, just because the weight class that he is in, all of those things. It's not a disrespectful thing, it's just me trying to categorize them the way that I think they should be categorized. Peyton Talbot, swagger, 25 years old. Like I said, Carlos Prates, 31, a little bit almost over that hedge. But again, Cameron Simon, unbelievable that he was able to do what he did to him. I know people may not be high on him. He is a very, very good fighter and a guy that hasn't really been hurt necessarily, especially the way that Talbot did. Talbot beat him up. Unbelievable. I mean, like I said, he has 9-0, seven wins by finish, one by submission. Didn't look great in his debut, but destroyed him once he got into rhythm. Looks really good. Just that Cameron Simon fight's unbelievable. Is coming off of a 19-second finish against Yanis Gamagori, who is okay, you know, okay. But Peyton Talbot is the real deal, I personally think. So, number three, this is an interesting one. Number three is Mauricio Ruffi, 28 years old, 10-1. The reason why he's number three is 10 finishes, one finish. His loss is a finish against Manuel Sosa. If you haven't watched that fight, go watch it back in 2019. Jamie Mullarkey absolutely mauled Mullarkey, which that's not shocking at all. Destroyed in the contender series. This guy is an absolute monster, has tons of swag. This guy is a finish machine. It fights in the lightweight division. The sky is the limit for this guy. The sky is the limit for Peyton Talbot, 28 years old. I really, really like Mauricio Ruffi, and we just need to see more on a five-fight winning streak, fighting nerds as well. That's the gym he trains at. This guy is a monster. So does Carlos Prates. He's at also fighting nerds. And as always, guys, let me know. Number two, here we go. Number two is Gene Matsumoto. Gene Matsumoto at 15-0, only 24, will be 25 in September. This guy is a monster. He had nine finishes out of his 15 wins. He has only two finishes in the first round, which is awesome, honestly, because it shows that his cardio is still good. You know, five submissions in the second, two in the third, TKOs in the third. Six decisions, like I said, all of them are unanimous. This guy is so much fun. Beating Dan Argueta the way he did, which maybe Dan Argueta isn't a great, like, oh, this guy's great. Maybe not, but he's 9-1 at the time, had success early, and as soon as Gene Matsumoto found the finish, he as soon as he found that neck, it was gone. There was no getting out of it. His cardio looked weird at first, and then it looked great. This guy is an absolute monster. I really like Matsumoto. The sky's the limit for him as well. Was finished as an amateur, and he has not since lost. This guy is so fun, so good. I really hope we get some more fight announcements from him very, very soon. But that guy, man, he is awesome. Whew, number one. And my number one prospect you need to watch out in 2024 on Omar Sy, baby. Omar Sy. This guy at 10-0, I understand he's not proven. He's 28 years old, 6'4", with an 83-inch reach at light heavyweight. This guy is so good. 8 finishes out of his 10 wins, 2 decisions. Turcos, it's a weird one for sure because it's a short notice. He was supposed to fight Antonio Tricoli, which we know what he would have done against him. He had a lot of canceled fights for sure. It's just being the wrestler that he is and sticking to game plans is very key to get high in a division, in rankings. He may not be the most flashy guy. The finishes will come if they come. Like, if you don't go for him, sure, maybe you could have gotten one, fine. But you can also put yourself in harm's way and get finished if you want. This guy right here fighting Dan Wu Choi in September 28th card, a day after my birthday. This guy, Dan Wu Choi, is on 3-5 losing streak. Was a big finisher there for a second. Big winner, at least, there for a second. Went to a draw with Sam Alvey, which is awful. Destroyed Mike Rodriguez, you know, William Knight, bad, KO'd Kennedy and Sekichu. Lost to Dustin Jacoby by finish. Devin Clark beat him. Carlos Olberg beat him. Carlos Olberg didn't look great in that fight either, but this is an interesting one because Dan Wu Choi is tall. You know, Omar Sy is, like I said, 6'4", and 83-inch reach. You look at Dung Woon Jung, I mean, this guy's 6'4", and 78.5 inch reach, so same height, but what, 4 is 82, so 4.5 inch reach for Omar Sy. Omar Sy, again, is that guy. I understand he beat a guy that took a fight on short notice. It's just how he did it, how explosive he looked, how calm he looked, how dominant he looked. It's just, there's certain victories to where you're like, okay, if that guy can stick to game plans, he's going to be a special one for sure. So those are my 5 that I really, really like. Let me know down below. 100%. Thank you for watching. And don't forget to share your favorite prospects in the comments below. If you want to stay up to date with all the latest UFC news and updates, subscribe to the channel. Let me know for sure. Notification bell. I'll see you in the next video. And as always, thanks for watching. Peace.